So today, class 10th, we are going to start with the topic analytical paragraph, which comes under the heading of data interpretation. So data interpretation we have already discussed also. And now, in order to have a wider view of the topic, so today we are going to discuss it again. So I think that you people will be refreshed again in your minds with the main points that I have already discussed with you. So let us start with these points that what an analytical paragraph is. So what is an analytical paragraph? Now in case of analytical paragraph, a pie chart, a histogram, a line graph, it can be given. And what you have to do in exams, in case of writing skills, you have to explain that graph in the form of a paragraph. So ultimately, you have to completely give a clear picture what the graph says, what the graph explains. So ultimately, it gives a true picture of the graph. Moreover, it gives complete information and it is written in the form of a paragraph. So analytical paragraph, it is a form of descriptive paragraph or descriptive writing. And what should one write? One should give a clear picture, what is written, what is mentioned in the graph, along with giving complete information. No personal observations are to be given here. So if I talk about the main features, what are the main features? Students are still entering, I don't know why. So what are the main features here? So the main features is this paragraph, it describes given chart. This is the first main purpose, that the given graph, it is going to be described, it is going to be explained in the descriptive writing. Secondly, it must be brief and comprehensive. Brief and comprehensive means it must be related to the points given. It must be related to what is given in the paragraph. It doesn't mean that you should include or you should beat about the bush. You will talk about the other things, how it can be done, how it can be solved. No, that is not your purpose. Okay? So your purpose is only to explain, just be brief and comprehensive in order to explain it. And it only states the facts, which facts, which are given in, which are being displayed in the form of a graph. Okay, you are only going to state only facts, nothing else you will write down. And clearly mention the figures and quantities given. Yes. You have to clearly mention whatever the figures. So you can very well imagine that can any graph be complete without figures as well as quantities? No, not at all. The graph cannot be complete without any kind of, you can say, figures and quantities. So ultimately you have to mention all the figures and the quantities clearly so that the reader will have a clear idea what the graph actually wants to explain. If it is giving out the figures, one should come to know from the paragraph which you have written that what figures this graph is going to explain or what figures this graph is displaying. Next, afterwards, no personal observations. So you will not add on your personal observation. You will not add on your personal comments or what is the going trend. You will only explain what is being only written there, and preferably use passive form. And which form you will use in order to write it? Usually passive form. And don't forget to make comparisons between various figures given. So don't forget to make these comparisons. You have to make these comparisons among various figures which are given here. Right, so these are the main points that you will keep in mind in order to write descriptive paragraph. Okay, now I'm going to discuss the format. So let me rub it down. So if I talk about the format, so first of all, you will give introduction in 2 to 3 lines, explain what you have to explain? Explain what this paragraph is about. Just a moment. So explain what this graph is about. Okay, so this is the starting of your introduction. You will explain what this paragraph is about or what is the subject of the paragraph. Then you will come up to body of this paragraph. So here what you will do, you will explain in detail the trends shown in a graph given. You will clearly explain what trends, what figures are being displayed. You will use relevant figures also. You will make use relevant figures. Make comparisons also. Make comparison. Yes, this is the most important thing. You will make comparisons. Mostly it is written in one paragraph, but wherever the need arises, you can divide it into more paragraphs, but usually it is written in one single paragraph. Then afterwards, after writing body, you will come up to conclusion. Finally, the conclusion is to be written. It means that you will conclude the paragraph, giving overall view or summary of the graph. You will conclude the paragraph using overall summary of the graph given. So this is how this descriptive paragraph it is going to be written. First of all, introduction in one or two lines or two to three lines. Explain what is the subject of the graph. Then coming up to body, here you will explain in detail what are the trends, how it is going to rise, how it is going to fall, and what are the relevant figures to be used. Then afterwards, conclude, right? Conclude, it means that you have to conclude the paragraph giving an overall view or giving an overall idea of the graph which was given to you. So you must be remembering that at that time when I have discussed with you this analytical paragraph, I have used number of, you can say, expressions with you. So let us revise these. For introduction, what you have to use? Anybody wants to unmute? Just raise up your hand, whosoever remembers, so that I can unmute. Can I expect this from your class? No, everyone is blank. Okay, so what this chart describes this chart explains this chart gives a view of any other thing you remember, or line graph shows similarly the bar graph, histogram, or the pie chart shows, the pie chart illustrates . So in this manner you will use, right? So for describing trends, when you have to describe the trends, for trends what you will write down? There is an increase, there is a decrease. So this shows a pattern of growth. The dash shoots up. The figures skyrocketed. Or it has plummeted. when it is coming down, it is leveled off, shows a hike. When there is increase, then you will write down that it shows a hike of, okay, it started to fall, it started to drop down, or started to fall, then started to drop down. So these are the various trends that you can use, okay, in order to show that whether there is increase or decrease. So you have to use these expressions in order to make your descriptive paragraph impressive, for introduction, and these are for showing various trends. Now another thing that I have told you is that while writing this descriptive paragraph, you have to make various kinds of comparisons too. So for comparisons also, how you can write down, for example, suppose 48% of, 30% of, okay, nearly 1/4 of. Okay, or on an average, twice as, right? Almost equal, very close to, almost equal. Very close to. So these things you can use, okay? Now you have to make various comparisons, okay? You can describe the quantities, or for comparisons you can also write in comparison to, in contrast to, okay? However, where it leads to. Finally, you will write down the conclusion. For conclusion, you will also use various kinds of expressions. Can anybody remember which kind of expressions you will use? For example, overall, subsequently, in all, in nutshell, overall, subsequently, in nutshell. So these kind of expressions you will use, okay? Or still one more child, I think some problem is there in this connection. So this is how you have to explain these trends in case of descriptive paragraph. Now before moving further, any doubt, if you have, you can raise up your hands. If you have any doubt, you can raise up your hands. It means no doubt to anyone. Clear? So just keep in mind that you have to use these expressions in order to write down descriptive paragraph. Now on the board, I'm drawing a bar graph which you have to explain. So side by side, you will also note it down. Later on, we will write down the question, please. Next is July to October. Now, the third one at 250. right? Then it is coming again to 200. If you have doubt in the quantities that where it refers to, you can ask me. This is at 50, this is at 200, this is at 250, this is again at 200, and this is at 100. These are the various months: June, July, August, this is September, and this is October. So the question is, the given chart shows, the cause of dengue, it's the cases of dengue. Dengue reported in Delhi now. Keeping the information provided by the graph, write an analytical paragraph. Yes, you have to write down an analytical paragraph for this, right? For analytical paragraph, let us start now. You can have it in. So these are the different trends. So here is graph in front of you that you have to describe. So as I told you, first of all, what we have to write down, we have to write down the introduction. So what this graph represents, just raise up your hands. Can anybody tell? Yes, Bhumika wants to ask. Yes, Bhumika.
Ma'am, yes. Ma'am, the above bar graph shows the cases of dengue reported in Delhi. The table suggests that the cases are increasing and decreasing.
Let us start first of all with the introduction. Yes. So the given bar graph, it represents the number of cases of dengue being reported in Delhi. So this, the bar graph or the bar graph given, it represents rise and fall. Okay, what it represents from here, it is rising and again it is going down. It represents the rise and fall of the number of cases of dengue which were reported in Delhi. So this was our introduction which has been done. Now after the introduction, we have to write about the body. Now showing various trends and making various comparisons. So now from this bar graph, what you have observed, you just tell me. What you have observed? Yes, what you have observed? Can anybody tell? I don't know why in your class, the problem is only with class 10 that you people are always mute, not speaking anything. I don't think so. You people always take initiative to speak. Yes, Ruhani. Yes, Rohani.
Yes, ma'am. That is the highest.
Yes.
Ma'am, in the month of August, the number of cases reported is the highest.
At the highest point. So let us make again one chart. So now the bar graph, it clearly represents that the number of cases which were reported in the month of August were at the highest level, or the highest number of cases were reported during the month of August. Then compare these two quantities which are at the same level. Okay, so you have to observe it. If the number of cases are almost equal being reported in the month of July and September, but in the month of June it has thrice going down, or the number of cases has decreased three times in the month of June, right? So we are using various quantities to make comparisons, or it has decreased to its one third in the month of June. However, again in the month of October, we have seen a little rise. Okay, what we have seen? We have seen a little rise in the number of cases, which were 100 in number being reported, and that was little bit higher, or that was little bit higher than the month of June. Or here, for example, you have mentioned about August. You can also write down that the number of cases, they have skyrocketed in the month of August. Okay, they have risen to their highest number. So in this manner, you need not to explain the exact figures like 50, 100, 150, 200, 250. No, this is not the reason that you have to explain these. What actually is, you have to make comparisons. You have to use various quantities in order to describe this number, right? So this is completely the body, okay? Right, next afterwards, conclusion. What is the conclusion? So what you have observed from this graph? So overall, this graph, or the bar graph, it gives a clear idea of the cases of dengue, which were in rise in the month of August, but finally, due to various precautionary measures taken by the government as well as the public, it started going down. And it has leveled off, but not it has gone to its lowest point, but there seem to be decrease in the number of cases. That's all. So here I have not beaten about the bush. I have not spoken anything else. I have written only what is given in the graph. I have only mentioned what is explained in the graph, nothing else than that. I have not given any my personal observations. I have used passive form also. These all were the points which I have discussed in the starting. So this is how this graph is to be written. Okay. So one in the next writing skill topic, I will discuss one more pie chart. Or if I will give you pie chart, I hope that you people will be able to do. Right. So let me give you a pie chart. You just note it down, make it in your notebooks. And this has to be done in your FAIR notebooks. And now let me give you a pie chart that we have to discuss. Should I rub it down? Just tell me. Should I? Show me your thumbs up. Okay, fine. Right. I'm going to rub it down. And I'm going to make a pie chart that we will explain in our next class. So here is a pie chart. Let me see from the book. You have to make it in your notebooks. This is 20. I'll write it down afterwards. So here it is. Yes. So this is going to be 26%. This is 24%. This is 9%, 15%, 14%, and this is 7%, and this is going to be 5%. But what all these refer to? Now let me shade it accordingly, so that you can have a clear image of it. Because otherwise in your exam, it will be given in the form of shaded portion. Something to be light, something to be dark. But here I'm not able to display it in that form. This is the reason why I'm making it in this form. Right? And now, so let us write down this shaded portion is sole parents. Note it down, just 5 to 6 minutes are left. Sole parents. Then this 24% one is singles without children. This is going to be complicated. This is one of the, you can say, sample paper one appeared in board exams. So you have to be very particular how to do that. Still students are admitting, I don't know why. Next, the circle one is aged couples. This we will do in the next class, and you will remind me where I have to make the circles and where I have made and all that. And then 15%, this one, this is couples with children. This is all households. And next, this is single and aged persons. Single and aged persons. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. One is left. Which one? 9% one. Yes. This is. These are couples without children. Okay, so this we are going to do in our next class. you can make it on your notebooks wherever you have, so that we can have the description. And this also you will do it on your own. Then I will listen to you, then I will give you the exact picture what this graph is going to display. And that's all for today.